Hello everyone. Good morning. Let's start with sway frame using moment distribution method. Dear student, till we have understood about the whole scenario of the moment distribution method, and we have analyzed lots of beam and non-sway frame. Today we are going to analyze the frame which is sway due to different criteria as we discussed in our last lecture. So let's start with one example of non-sway frame analysis. In this, here one example, that is, analyze the portal frame shown in figure below by moment distribution method and draw bending moment diagram and shear force diagram. So basically this frame is always a sway frame because there is a horizontal force on this frame. Here the frame having A to B, which is acted as a column, and its length is 5 meter. B to C, that is beam having UDL with 5 kN into meter, and at C nodal force, that is 20 kN towards the right. And C to D, again it is column and its length is 4 meter. In this case, the flexural rigidity of AB, that is I, B to C, that is 2I, and C to D, that is I. So for the analysis of any frame, we must have to take consideration that this frame is sway frame. Now for the any cases of moment distribution method, we must have to find out the fixed end moment, and which is over here. For A to B, there is no load on the span, that's why fixed end moment of AB is 0. Same fixed end moment from B to A, that is 0. On B to C, there is a UDL, that's why fixed end moment of BC, that is minus WL square by 12, so it is minus 3.75 kilonewton into meter. And MFCB, that is plus WL square by 12, that is 3.75 kilonewton into meter. Again from C to D, there is no span load, that's why fixed end moment for C to D and D to C, that is 0. So the fixed end moment is our first step of any example. Now the second thing, that is distribution factor. Here we have two joint B and C, both are connected with two member. That's first, B joint is connected with B to A and B to C. B to A, there is far end is fixed, that's why 4EI by L, so it is 0.858EI. From B to C, that is 4, and here the flexural rigidity is 2i, that's why 4e2i upon span, it is 2.67 EI. so summation of these two, that is 3.47. so 0.8 divided by 3.47, we will get 0.23, and for B to C it is 0.77. same way joint C, it is also connected with two member, C to B and C to D. Here the far end is continuous, that's why 4e into 2i upon 3, that's why 2.67 EI. and the next C to D, that is 4EI by 4, because the far end is fixed. So here we will get 1. So summation of these two, 3.67 EI. so K upon sigma K, that is distribution factor, and which is 0.73. and for C2D that is 0.27. Now A and D both joint are fixed, so the fixed distribution factor is always 0 for that fixed support. Now we have all the distribution factor. So first of all, for this way analysis of frame, we must have to finding out the moment distribution for the non-sway. So here we have to just consider that first the frame is non-sway. So what the non-sway analysis? Here A, B, C and D for joint over here, and the distribution factor that we have already finding out, and fix end moment it is also we have. So first fix end moment, and both the ends are fixed and continuous, that's why no need to initial balance and carry over. So directly we can start the distribution from over here, and we will take some from the fix end moment. So what we will get here, it is 0. The summation of these two multiply with this, we will get 0.86, here 2.88, minus 2.74, minus 1, the balance. Same way, carry over, we will get this one, again balance, carry over. After the getting value near by the 0 point or 0, we will stop our cycle of the balance and carry over. Now, we will going to summation of this all moment from over here. So we will get 0.65 at A, 1.335 at B, 2A and B to C we will get minus 1.335. Whenever we will get the value over here, both are same, one positive and one negative, our calculation is true, that we can identify. Now next at C, the summation we will get 1.59 and here minus 1.59, so we are correct, and from here it is minus 0.765. so we will get the final support moment for the non-sway analysis. From this we can just calculate that our frame due to non-sway is going somewhere rightwards or somewhere leftwards. So we have to finalize that. For that we have to take and finding out the reaction at the supports due to this moment. So we will get here B2A and C2D both are column. Always column are sway in any frame. So due to this moment we are going to take fixed and free body diagram of AB and the reaction at A, that is HA. So we will get some reaction from here, and that is HA is 0.397 kilonewton. It is plus, that's why our consideration towards the right, that is true. So it is 0.397 kilonewton towards the right. The same calculation for C2D. So we have to take the free body diagram of C2D and we will assume that the reaction is towards the left, and whenever we finding out the reaction at D, it is plus, then our consideration towards the left of reaction at D, that is true, that's why it is 0.588 kilonewton towards the left. Now from these two reaction we will get some net horizontal reaction, and that is 0.191 kilonewton towards the left. Now we have the force that is given in example at C, that is plus 20, means it is towards the right, and reaction we will get, that is left. So due to non-sway moment, our actual sway, that is 19.809 kilonewton, which is towards the right. Now we can consider that our frame is sway towards the right. So at C and B joint, that sway is considered due to moment acting at B and C is anticlockwise. So, as the wave force is towards the right, column A and B will be rotates in clockwise direction. So, column are rotate in clockwise direction because of this will induce the anticlockwise moment at the column heads. At B and C joint, both the moments are anticlockwise. That's why the column is rotates towards the clockwise, means it is towards the right. Now, as we discussed, for the calculation of sway analysis, we must have to take the ratio of moment of particular column due to that moment, and that is 6 EI delta upon L square. Again here 6 EI delta upon L square, but the length of the both column are different. So, we will get the ratio of that moment is 0.64, and here we always consider that the delta is 1. So, this two equation 6 EI delta upon L square, that is already predefined and proven in our last subject, last semester subject SA1, and in that subject we have studied about the fixed beam. In that case we have finding out these two equations. So, here moment from B to A is equal to 0.64 moment due to CD. Now, our moment at column head, that is anticlockwise, so we are considering any one moment, that moment at CD and DC, that is minus 10 kilonewton into meter, it is anticlockwise. So, moment due to BA, that is 0.64 into minus 10. So, we will get at B to A moment, that is 6.4, A to B, that is again minus 6.4. Now, we will perform this sway analysis considering about the arbitrary moment. This arbitrary moment is useful for the moment distribution of sway frame, as well as from that we will get some reaction, and we will finding out the sway due to this arbitrary moment. So, now again we have to make the table of moment distribution, and it is the sway analysis of our frame. So, here we have minus 6.4. B to C, there is no moment induced because it is 0. And here minus 10 at C to D. Now, we have the distribution factor at V just before finding out, and that we have fixed end moment here also we have. So, now again the moment distribution of this fixed end moment, and we have to finding out the balance carryover. Due to this, we will get some again support moment, and that -5.9, -5.68, +5.68, +7.69, -7.69, and -8.79. So, this final moment at support is just arbitrary moment due to that minus 10 kilonewton into meter moment we have considered. So, again we have to finding out the reaction due to this arbitrary moment, and again we have to make free body diagram of AB, free body diagram of CD, and here both the moment at column, that is anticlockwise, due to that we will get HA, right, and that HA is 2.332 kilonewton towards the left. Same way for the CD column, again we have to finding out the reaction at D due to this arbitrary moment, and we will get the value, that is HD, it is also 4.12 kilonewton. Now, these two reaction will give us the net horizontal reaction, that is 6.452 kilonewton towards the left. this reaction indicated that if reaction towards the left, then sway of frame is towards the right. Due to that arbitrary moment, our arbitrary sway force is 6.452 towards the right. But as we discussed, our actual sway, that is 19.890 towards the right. So this arbitrary moment at support is now corrected from these two values. When our sway is 6.452, we have the support moment, that is -5.98, -5.68, +5.68, 7.69, -7.69, and -8.79. Now, what we have to do? We must have to correct this value of support moment as compared to sway force. So, whenever sway force is 6.42, here the value is -5.98. But when our actual sway is this one, then the value is -18.36. एक्चुअली यहाँ पे हमने क्या किया कि अगर फोर्स हमारा इतना है तो यहाँ पे मोमेंट इतनी, अगर स्वे इतना होता तो कितनी होती, देन वी विल गेट दिस वैल्यू. सो वी हैव टू करेक्ट दिस वैल्यू एज दिस वन. नाउ आवर नॉन स्वे एनालिसिस इज done by us, and at that time we will get some value of the support moment. Now the final support moment is summation of these two, here summation of these two, right? And after that we will get the value, that support moment is this one. Now finally we will get the our actual value of support moment due to sway and non-sway, both the analysis, and this support moment will used for the draw of bending moment diagram as well as for the shear force diagram. Again we have to finding out the actual reaction due to this moment and the actual load. So we will get the again reaction at A and reaction at D. So what we will get due to the actual moment, our reaction at A, that is 6.76 kilonewton towards the left for the FBD of AB, and FBD of CD we will get the HD, that is 13.23 kilonewton due to moment towards the left. So our net horizontal reaction, that is 20 kilonewton. So here we can again check that this reaction must be equal to our actual force which is acting on a frame is 20. So we are correct over here. So dear student, in this non-sway analysis we must have to consider that our all the values of reaction is most important for the analysis of sway frame. Now whenever we want to finding out the bending moment diagram, we must have to finding out the span moment, and here span AB there is no load, so it is 0. Span BC there is UDL, so it is WL square by 8, that we know, and it is 5.62 kilonewton into meter. Now at span CD there is also no load, so it is 0. Now after getting all the reactions, all the moments, and we have this much load which is acting on frame, from these loads and these moments we have to finding out the again our vertical reaction at the support, and that is VA and VD. So here whenever we finding out this, we will get the reaction at D, that is 21.27, and it is plus, so it is upward, and VA is getting -6.27. So our reaction is downward. Now we have all the moments, all the reaction, horizontal and vertical reaction. So we will calculate our diagram of bending moment and shear force. So here at A, that is anti-clockwise moment, which is bend our column towards the left, and here at B, that moment that is anti-clockwise. So here we will get this one bending moment. Now at BC we have span moment that is 5.62, and at C negative moment, support moment that is 25.22. It is clockwise, so it is moving upward our column, and here it is anti-clockwise, so it is towards the right. And at D, that is anti-clockwise moment, it is move our column towards the left. So whenever we are going to connect this all value, we will get this bending moment diagram of our frame. Now the next and important thing, that is shear force diagram, and we will get this shear force. Here HA is towards the left, so it is 6.76. Whenever move upward, it is towards the right, so it is 6.76 and it is plus. Here at B means reaction towards the downward, so the value is 6.27 towards the downward, minus our UDL, so we will get -21.27, and reaction at upward, that is 21.27, it is upward. At CD, the value that is 13.23 towards the right, and here the reaction towards the left. So this diagram also we will consider as a rectangle. Now this is outward, means it is plus. Here it is also outward, it is plus, and this is inward, means it is minus. So this our shear force diagram. Now the diagram of bending moment and shear force is useful for the calculation of our frame dimension as well as reinforcement inside the column. So dear student, whenever we have this kind of sway frame, we must have to consider that there are two type of analysis, non-sway and sway analysis. From that we will get the reactions, and that reaction gives us the idea about the sway towards left or right, and after that we will consider the sway analysis. So here you can get the clear idea about the frame. Thank you. In next lecture again we will take another example of frame, which is important for us. Thank you. Thank you very much.